G'day everyone, it is Curtis here and welcome to an On The Back Wheel video. Today I'm taking out the Triumph Rocket 3 GT for its first ride. The weather is absolutely terrible, but it's going to be like this for the next like 10 days, so I thought, let's just get out and shoot a video. So it could be a bit wild, we'll see how we go. This is just going to be a short ride. I have ridden it to and from work a couple of times, but I thought I'd hook up the camera and take it on this little back road section up here so we can get a feel for the bike, and I'll let you know my first impressions of it. I have to say, it's a pretty cool looking bike. I love the colours. The paintwork and everything looks fantastic. It's a cool looking bike. I mean, look at this motor. Look at the size of the sucker. 2,500 cc's. What a beast. Oh, one other thing, look at this front tire. It's bigger than a lot of normal motorbikes rear tire. Look at that sucker, it's huge. And the rear tire isn't much better. Look at it, it's huge. I know nearly nothing about the motorcycle. I just know it's got a massive motor, so this is going to be a great first impression. I haven't touched anything, haven't touched the suspension. We'll do that for the review. We'll tweak all the settings on the review as well. I'm just going to get on it, put it on road mode, because rain mode is for sissies. Like, who needs rain mode? So this will be a really good test of the traction control. Let's get on the sucker and ride. Let's do it. Oh, okay. I can tell you this. After riding adventure bikes for a fair while recently and sports bikes, this feels weird. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Look at the motor, look at that bike twist. He wants to straighten this way when you rev it. Alright, let's get into it. Forward controls, always a big change. Apologies if I get water on the camera. There's a lot of rain about and can't really avoid that, unfortunately. Let's go across here. Alright. Let's see how the traction control works. That's a lot of grunt, everyone. Traction control is working overtime. Clutch feels great. The seating position feels weird, different, unusual. I'm not used to riding cruisers, but it just feels weird to me. I'm sure I'll get used to it. Doesn't feel as heavy as you would think. Oh, turning wise, get over there. A bit understeery feeling. Feels like you're really going to manhandle it, and in this kind of weather conditions where it's bucketing down rain, you're kind of hesitant to. Oh, suspension feels stiff as a board. I'm not sure what settings it's at, but it feels pretty bad. How good's this weather, everyone? Oh, it's terrible. I'm riding home from work, so I thought, let's just record something anyway. Get it done, you know, get something out there. No quick shifter. Interesting to note. I think that's a big miss. We'll see how I feel after a couple weeks. I like how your knees fit in the tank. It's a nice shape and design there. Not even trying it, just spinning up. We'll go left here and a bit of a back way. So I don't know the exact specs on this yet. I'll look them up during the couple weeks I got this, but I'll tell you this. Feels like it's got a boatload of torque, like a lot. Some serious yank in all gears. Hey, it sounds pretty cool, doesn't it? Woo, woo, woo. Oh, water on the road up here. It's bloody flooding. Let's have those front brakes. Sensational. Ah, look at this. What have we got here? More water across the road. If it's flat, it floor it. Whee! Adventure Bike Rocket 3. Goodness, it's got some grunt. like a lot of grunt. Feels like you gotta use your whole body to turn. Whoa, it's effortlessly fast. I was just doing like 90 odd and it felt like I was going extremely slow. All right, let's see how it goes through this section. It's fast, but it doesn't feel like scary fast. Where it feels ridiculous is, let's say you go in the fourth gear, it just got a lot of shove. Like it's more that wave of torque. Feels like it's never revving. Feels like you're just idling everywhere. Great conditions for a first ride impressions, isn't it? It actually doesn't feel overly heavy. Here's a cool bit. Third gear, that's a little bit vibey at these lower revs, like a. Not bad, definitely noticeable. Once it gets going, it's really smooth though. Tiny bit of vibration through the bars. Ooh. Feels pretty good through this section. The tight stuff, it feels terrible. These tight corners. But when it's a bit more flowy, it feels quite good. This slow stuff, oh goodness. The suspension setup is terrible. Well, I hope it's the setup. It's very jarring and stiff. Like crashing almost. I know it's a heavy bike, but it feels like sports bike stiff. We'll have to see if that's a setup over the couple of weeks I got it. I'll give it a good tweak. Set it to the recommended settings first, if it's not already. And go from there. Oh, bit of a throttle jack there. It throws you back though, I'll tell you that for sure. Even just that little yank then, it throws you back in the seat. The seating position is quite comfortable. I like how scalloped the seat is. Feels nice, legs are in a nice position. My back is getting a little bit sore. I kind of alternate between sitting upright and then being hunched over. Hunched over is obviously not good for you, but it's where I'm at as a person, where a lot of people are. Bars feel like a bit of a reach forward for me. Could be a tiny bit further up. A little bit further back, maybe. Look at this, beautiful. Gearbox feels great. Feels fantastic. Oh, there's that rain. Tell you what, high speeds come around really quick on this and it doesn't feel like it's going that fast and you look down and go, oh my goodness, I am well over the speed limit. Go to jail speeds. So I'm loping along here, 60 kilometers per hour in third. It feels like I'm idling. It really just feels ridiculous. It feels like the bike's not working at all. One thing so far, fuel economy is woeful. Not that you get a Rocket 3 to think about fuel economy, but my average is 8 liters per 100 kilometers. That is terrible. 80 kilometers per hour. Feeling very comfortable. A little bit of wind, but no like bad buffeting. I've got earbuds in, which cuts out a lot of noise, but it feels fine. Feels completely fine. Stable. Stretch it out a bit. Sixth gear, 100 kilometers an hour. Just over 2000 RPM. Whoa. No traction. My throttle's barely open. This thing is effortlessly fast. Like six gear, this feels like I'm in way too tall a gear. Six gear feels like you should be sitting at a lot higher speeds. Actually, when you get up to speed a bit, there's a fair bit of wind. There's not much going on here. You've got this dicky little screen at the front. I don't know how much that does. It's got one. Well, we got some flooding. Rocket 3, baby. Adventure touring bike, that's what this is. Don't worry about confused power cruiser. Alright, let's do a slow speed manoeuvre. Turn, foot's up, oh, foot down, that's a fail. Speed up this time, tight. Yeah, it's cumbersome. I'm new on the bike, but it's a little bit cumbersome. It's a big thing. Through the water, slow down. That's a lot of water. Alright, let's see if it's a bit grippy here. Yeah, that's just effortlessly fast. It's not like scary fast. It's just, you look down and you're like, whoa, I'm going that fast. Uh-oh, better slow down. Also not getting a lot of grip. It's proper quick, don't get me wrong. Proper quick. Feels completely stable for cruising. Completely stable.
Alright, just got home. It's starting to get dark and it's time to give my initial impressions on the Rocket 3 GT. I don't know what to think of this. It is a confusing bike. Based off just like a 15 minute test ride, I would have given the keys back and said, thanks, but no thanks. I'll see you later, because I didn't like it at all. Now I've gone on a better ride. It's starting to grow on me, but I still don't love it, definitely don't. The motor is outrageous. It's stupidly fun. It's an outrageous bike, but yeah, I'm gonna need the full 2 weeks to really get a feel for this. Adjust the suspension, it feels terrible for me at the moment. The brakes are amazing. It doesn't feel as big as it is. Don't get me wrong, it's still a massive bike. But yeah, it's reasonably maneuverable for the size of it. It's still big and awkward. But yeah, if you've got any questions on the Rocket 3, put them in the comments below. I mean, it's fast. I'll tell you that for sure. It is very fast. It's kind of a different, it's not sports bike fast. It's like you just roll it on, you get this shove of torque, like boom. And then next thing you know, you're doing well over twice the speed limit. And you go, what the hell, where'd that come from? It's an outrageous bike. And it does have a lot of street appeal. I've already had multiple people like rev heads going like, yeah, rev it up, and give me the thumbs up and stuff. So it's a cool bike. But yeah, I'm gonna need to ride it some more. That's the short, I need to ride it more to get a real feel for it. It does look pretty cool though, like the paintwork and everything is amazing. Okay, I'm starting to get really wet. The rain is coming down again. Hopefully it clears up. It's supposed to rain for like 10 days straight and we can get some good dry riding on this, do a bit of touring as well. All right, if you haven't, hit the subscribe button and keep it on the back where everyone catches.